Hi, I'm Brian Wallet. I'm an associate professor at Georgetown University and an attending physician at the MedStar Washington Hospital Center. My poster is entitled The Prevalence and Antecedents of Fibromyalgia in the Elderly. This is a study about fibromyalgia in older women. We took the Women's Health Initiative, which is a cohort that's been around now for almost 20 years, that looked at postmenopausal women and the things that happened to them over time. We took a subset of this cohort, about 1,000 women, and we administered a questionnaire based on the 2010 fibromyalgia criteria. This allowed us to get a sense of fibromyalgia prevalence in an elderly woman cohort. The women were about age 78 at the time of their measurements. What we found is about 6.6% of women in this cohort met the criteria for the diagnosis of fibromyalgia. This is more than you would expect in the general population, where you would expect there to be a 2 to 4% prevalence rate of fibromyalgia. And we make a nice little graph that shows you how symptoms look like in normal populations and in our older population, where you see that more people have symptoms as they get older, and more people end up meeting criteria for fibromyalgia. Well, we then looked at differences between patients that do and do not have fibromyalgia and found that there are not very many differences. The only thing that really seems to matter is socioeconomic status, or the amount of money that one makes, that people who make less money tend to have more symptoms and are more likelihood of having fibromyalgia. One nice part about this study is that at baseline, 17 years prior to us doing our questionnaire, a whole lot of questions about different types of symptoms were measured in these patients. And what we find is that symptoms 17 years prior are very predictive of having fibromyalgia later. And by symptoms, I mean things like pain, but I also mean things like clumsiness, dizziness, headaches, bowel problems, and so on. You can see the poster for that. In a multivariate model to make the best model for what predicts, it turns out that pain, neck pain, constipation, diarrhea, fatigue, and overall health are the most predictive things of having fibromyalgia in the future. Lastly, we try to remove people who had fibromyalgia at baseline and then see in the rest how other symptoms predicted future fibromyalgia. And what we found is that the number and the severity of symptoms at baseline can be powerfully predictive of future fibromyalgia 17 years later, even when you did not have that at baseline. In a nutshell, this suggests that symptoms predict future symptoms, which is not a new concept. It also suggests that the symptoms of fibromyalgia are common in the elderly. In our clinical practice, the diagnosis of fibromyalgia tends to be something we make in the young and middle-aged. And even though that they have it less than the symptoms less than we see in the elderly. For many of the elderly patients, they seem to have come to terms with their symptoms and either do not seek medical care for them or are given other reasons for having the symptoms, whether it be osteoarthritis or so on. And this sort of highlights some of the discordance between the actual presence of symptoms and how we label them in our medical practices.